Halatrax.
We can shake it off the dance floor.
I used to be in a band with Lauderdale, and we played a showcase at Hollywood Records, and the A&R at the time brought Kevin along with them. The A&R loved the show. Said, oh, you just need those hit songs. You should work with my buddy Kevin. His writing partner, Jacob Kasher, needed some songs for his project, so I just kept bringing him stuff. And he's like, oh, these are great. I'm going to take them to Kevin. He's like, just keep sending me stuff. So I sent him like 25 songs in a month. One day, Jacob called me up and said, yo, come on to California. And I was on a plane 2 days later. Kevin signed me, and now I'm working with him and doing a bunch of records. Couple singles and songs coming out. Christian TV, I did it with Kevin. Jesse McCartney, Think She Likes Me, Hollywood Undead, and all that stuff's coming out.
I just can't escape, it's like you're here with me now.
It's a lot of bands, but from what I gather from people back home is that there's not a lot of venues left, and like the scene is dying. Pop punk bands, pop rock bands, so I just wanted to be something different and just step outside the box a little bit and just do my own thing and do my own take on it.
Everything turned red and then you made an exit.
I moved out to LA because my boss, Kevin Rudolph, and one of the other writers I work with, Jacob Kasher, like they're all out here, and like being in Los Angeles, you're in the middle of the game. Like everyone's out here and everyone's doing their thing, and it's made me work harder and get better because I'm surrounded by all those people. Like, I need to step up my game if I want to compete with all of them.
But the words you say, they always...
Being from Fort Lauderdale and now moving to LA, it's really different. Everyone always asks you the first question, it seems like, what are you working on or what do you do? Like, I've always been in bars and just hear people saying and talking about, I'm working on this script, or I'm working with this person, or doing this project, and doing that, and it's just, it's almost hilarious to me, because I don't think you can pick up chicks like that. If you were planning on moving out to LA, and it kind of sounds a little mean, but you gotta have a plan. You gotta figure it out what you want to do. I've seen so many people get lost in the shuffle and not know what they do. And it's tough out here. It's a lot more expensive and you're competing with so many people, and that you have to step up and you have to know what you're going to do and what your worth is and how good you are. You need to believe in it, and you also have to let people know how good you are, and you have to show them with like all your music and your writing ability.
I'm just a face in the crowd.
It's definitely different, like my measure of success of being in a band and being producer. You're still trying to get the A&R's attention by your tracks and everything like that and how good your songs are, but it's just a whole new world, like a whole new game, and like I said, you're fighting against everyone. It's like a competition amongst yourself and like other producers, and I love it. It's like I'm in the jungle.
You make the rain fall.
Working with someone like Kevin Rudolph, it's really great. Sign him because he pushes me and he wants me to move it. He wants me to blow up and be a big producer. He's a creative person and he's a producer himself and like a great one. So he can tell me what is wrong with it in my tracks, or if I need to tweak this or fix that. My first taste of success was actually just getting signed and someone giving me the opportunity to do what I love and getting to do that every day. Like, that's amazing to me. Like, I get paid to do what I love. How many of you can actually say that?
No, I'll never change my ways, but every single night I pray.
I would really love to work with Justin Timberlake one day. I don't even know. She's really talented, really hot. Mostly because she's really hot.